We are live.
Hello everyone, everybody, welcome to this webinar from Cocoon Medical. First of all, I would like to thank you all for your attendance. So let me introduce myself. My name is David Rubio and I am the Global Clinical Training Director at Cocoon Medical. And it's a real pleasure to be with you all today during this session. Well, so let's start our webinar for today. So this webinar is about understanding the concept of triple wavelength and its benefits in laser hair removal in all skin types. Let me share with you my presentation. Okay, so as mentioned before, this is the webinar and it will be conducted by Dr. Gregorio Viera. Okay, so what about our company? What about Cocoon Medical? So let me give you some data and some details about Cocoon Medical. Cocoon Medical is a worldwide company and it was founded in 2010. Our headquarters are in Spain, in Barcelona, and currently we are working closely with 70 different distributors around the world. We also have our factory based in Sofia, in Bulgaria, and it was founded in 2016. Both places, Barcelona and Sofia, are very nice, really, really nice cities to have our headquarters and our factory. I suggest you all to visit both cities if you have the opportunity, because they are really wonderful and amazing. Okay, how is actually Cocoon Medical? How is the company and where are we? So let me give you some information about our wonderful company. Currently, we are 165 employees working together every single day worldwide to make it happen, to make everything runs properly, smoothly, professionally, and nicely for all our doctors and customers. We really love our doctors and customers. And one of our main goals in Cocoon Medical is to take care of them and to be able to give them the best technology and the best clinical training. Apart from our 165 direct employees, we also work closely with 70 different official distributors around the world. Of course, we also take care as much as possible of all of them, as we really believe in relationships with not only with our customers, but also with our distributors. We invest in R&D, of course. This is a very important point for us. In fact, we invest an 80% of our revenue in R&D, and it is very important for the company to be up to date about the latest and the best technology in the market. 70% of our sales are international. This demonstrates the incredible expansion and presence of the company worldwide. So, due to our wonderful amount of international sales, we are present in more than 70 different countries, of course, including Spain. And we also have 4 different international offices. What about our devices? Well, we have 9,000 devices installed around the world. And last but not least, we have 2 production facilities available. All these numbers and data are amazing. Don't you think that at the same way as me? Okay, so let me show you now our new facilities in Barcelona and in Sofia. Since Cocoon Medical is a dynamic company and this is that is in continuous growth and expansion, during this year, we are going to have a new headquarters in Barcelona and a new office in Sofia as well. As you can see in this slide, both have a wonderful design and they will let us give our customers and distributors even better and faster support. Okay, now I'm very excited and I'm very proud to introduce you all our key executives. On the left, you can see Miguel Pardos. He is the CEO of the company and he brings to Cocoon Medical a huge experience in the aesthetic market. As before joining Cocoon Medical, he was working in different aesthetic companies, such as Lumenis, Cutera, Sinoran Candela, and General Electric, holding different positions in the management team. On the right side, you can see José Antonio Sánchez. He founded Cocoon Medical in 2010. And of course, he also has a huge experience in the aesthetic field, as he was pioneer in the aesthetic market in Spain, starting in 1974. Mr. Sánchez is also the owner of 13 aesthetic clinics in Spain, and these clinics are currently the biggest chain of clinics in Barcelona. Okay, and finally, let me introduce you all our true starring for today. He is Dr. Gregorio Viera, and he is our Chief Technology Officer and Director of Scientific and Clinical Department in Cocoon Medical. He earned a PhD in physics in 2000 at the University of Barcelona. He also has 20 years of experience in non-invasive technologies for medical and aesthetic applications. He's a professional researcher of cutting-edge and highly competitive technological solutions, and he has published more than 50 publications internationally and has several patents and multiple presentations around the world. So he's not only an incredible professional, but also a wonderful and a great person. Dr. Viera, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to learn from you today and for making this webinar possible. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, David, for this kind presentation. It's for me a pleasure to be here, to have the opportunity to do this webinar. I would like to say thank you also to Sky Innovation for inviting me to this webinar. And of course, thank you to all the attendants to be here and to register to this webinar. We know that we are facing a very complex situation. Most of the companies around the world are in lockdown. Our aesthetical market is stopped. But the good news is that we are creating and doing new things. And we have, for example, today the opportunity to communicate with you and to show you our results, our products using this webinar. I am very, very happy to do it. I am here in Barcelona, in a small town in Barcelona. David is in Madrid and our distributor is in Mumbai. Okay, and you are around the world. This is a very incredible and nice experience for everybody. And we have to take profit of that. Okay. Then I'm going to start my presentation to show you the presentation. I would like to excuse because of my English is not very good, and also the presentation maybe is not the best presentation for a webinar. Okay, this is a presentation we prepare to do in a seminar, in a conference, and maybe it's not the best presentation for a webinar. But okay, this is the first webinar that I do. And I hope you enjoy this activity. Okay, let's show my screen. Okay, I will turn off my video so that you can follow better the presentation. Okay, then I have said the objective of this presentation is to show the benefits and advantages of the prime lace blend applicator and the main reason of their wavelengths, 800 nanometers, 940 and 1060, especially for high skin tights and for thin hair. Okay, in order to understand the benefits of the blend applicator, it's important to know first which are the differential factors of prime lace from the technological point of view. Here you will see one of the most important points of prime lace is its high power, much higher than most of the main products of the market. Then why is important the high power for hair removal? This will be the second point. And the next point would be to understand how important is the wavelength in the process of hair removal and why the blend applicator of Prime Lace is a very solution, good solution for high skin types. And finally, I will explain why we have chosen the combination of 800 nanometers, 940 and 1060, and not other combination that use 755 nanometers, for example. Okay, as you may know, the Prime Lace platform is the only device based on diode laser for hair removal that offers four different wavelengths. Diode lasers of 755, the same wavelength than alexandrite lasers, the standard diode laser of 800 nanometer that is used for all the products in the market, the diode lasers of 1060, okay, the same than neodymium jack, and the innovative and unique blend wavelength that is the subject of this webinar. With these four wavelengths, Prime Lace is a very flexible product that can be used in all markets around the world and by users who have different requirements or needs. Why Prime Lace? The first differential factor of Prime Lace is what we want to explain, is the high power of the diode lasers used in the Prime Lace. Here in Cocoon, we are experts in laser technology. When we started the project in 2010, we knew that the best laser in terms of efficacy and speed for hair removal is the alexandrite solid state laser. And that with the standard technology of diode lasers, we would never achieve similar performances. Then we developed a new diode laser of 300 watts, which represents a power 5 times higher than the standard diode laser for hair removal. Currently, Prime Lace is made from only 16 diode bars of 300 watts. Other products from the competence, also with high power, use a higher number of bars, usually more than 20. And this, of course, increases a lot the cost of the product. This new technology of high power diode bars allow us to offer a very powerful device, having a very competitive cost, because at the end, the number of bars are the most expensive component of the diode. And then in our device, the number is relatively low. The second important factor of Prime Lace is the high durability of our laser diodes. And there are two reasons to explain this. The first reason is because our diode lasers do not have heat sinks with microchannels. You may know that diode lasers need to be cooled by water. A microchannel is the most used cooling technology for high power diode because they superior cooling efficacy. However, microchannels are very sensible to the quality of the cooling liquid and can suffer corrosion if the water becomes conductive or suffer obstruction if there are particles therein. And this is fatal for the diodes because if the microchannel fault, then the diode will be burned. In fact, the degradation of the microchannel is the main reason of the diode failure and the reason why many diodes break after 3 million of shots. Then, in order to reduce the problem of the microchannels, the system, the laser system should use the ionized and filtered water, should have electronic components to monitor continuously the quality of the water, and also requires high maintenance. And at the end, very high requirements and precautions just only to prevent the degradation of the microchannels. We are not facing up with this problem. We are using a cooling technology, especially developed for high peak power diode lasers and for hair removal operation conditions. You know that hair removal use low frequency, 1 Hz, 2 Hz, maximum 10 Hz, and in our case, in the case of Prime Lace, short pulses. This means that the thermal requirements are not high, and there is no need to use microchannels. Instead of this, we are using macrochannels, big channels, especially designed for hair removal operation that don't suffer any of the problems of the microchannel. It means we can use industrial cooling liquid, and at the end, the channels will never be destroyed. As a consequence, the most important here is that the lifetime of our diodes is not limited by the lifetime of the etchings. Okay, the second reason to explain the high durability of our laser diode is because the lifetime is very high. First, because the pulses are shorter thanks to the higher peak power. And therefore, for a given total lifetime, we can provide more pulses. And second, during the development of this diode laser, we optimized the conditions to operate always under safe conditions and using the best specification for hair removal operation in terms of short pulses and high frequencies. It's important to remark that we have developed a system to know the temperature and the lifetime of the laser diodes under all the operation conditions used for hair removal. Here you can see an example of lifetime test performed at 5 milliseconds and high frequency, where we cannot see any degradation after 30 million of shots. Another advantage of PrimeLase is its highly homogeneous laser spot. The shape is rectangular because the laser beam of the diode laser has this shape, but the most important here is the high homogeneity of the laser spot, which is called top hat shape. Our laser diode don't include micro lenses or other sensible optical systems that can suffer easy misalignment. We have developed a special optical system for hair removal operation without micro lenses, extremely robust, which just provide an homogeneous top hat spot. This kind of spot are much more effective for hair removal than round or Gaussian spot, which are the typical one of the solid state lasers. And the reason is because they allow to produce a perfect overlapping between shots. It means that only one pass is enough to cover all the area treated. And as a result, the treatment is faster and more precise. And of course, an homogeneous spot produces an homogeneous heating, a safer result. The fourth differential factor of PrimeLase is that the laser pulse is perfectly square. The drivers has been developed with a very fast rise time, shorter than 200 microseconds, and without the spikes or overshootings that could produce the degradation of the laser diode. Most of the systems in the market have a rise time in the range of milliseconds. This means that laser cannot produce pulses of less than 10 milliseconds with a square shape. Okay. Then the result with PrimeLase is a uniform delivery of energy at the shortest pulse duration of 3 milliseconds. That at the end is a warranty of safe and effective results with short pulses. Other important advantage is the fact that PrimeLase can be used in different operation modes. On one hand, you have the typical static mode for hair removal, where you shot one time and move the applicator. Okay, the advantage of PrimeLase is that all the frequencies can be applied at the maximum frequencies of 3 Hz. While in other systems in the market, the speed decreases when the fluence increases, as in the case of doing treatments with light skin types or residual hair that requires high fluences. And then this kind of treatments could become too slow. Again, this advantage comes from the fact that we are using high powerful lasers that always provide short pulses. And the other operation mode of PrimeLase is the dynamic mode, which is done at higher frequencies between 5 and 10 Hz, where you do multiple passes on the same area using lower values of fluence. The difference between PrimeLase and other systems is that the dynamic mode of PrimeLase is performed at a very short pulses of few milliseconds, which means that although the fluence is quite small, The heating of the head is very high, and as a result, we can offer a dynamic mode with really high efficacy in hair removal. Even in dynamic mode, you can feel like needles during the hair removal operation. This is an operation mode recommended for first session with a large area and high hair density. It produces higher comfort for sensitive patients. It is also good for higher skin types on a safer way and can be used any time of the year with also tanned skin. Okay, as I have mentioned, all the parameters can be used at the maximum frequency. Here you can see the table of parameters in static mode and in dynamic mode that you can use in the primers. In static mode, all the fluencies can be done up to 40 joules. All the fluencies up to 40 joules can be done up to 3 hertz. And all the fluencies in dynamic can be done at 10 hertz. What does it mean? That prime lace will offer the maximum speed for all the treatments, independently of the parameters used. Of course, we can say that we have all the certifications required for the medical operation, and also all the required regulatory approvals for the different countries around the world. But at the end, what you are looking for is a hair removal device with high efficacy and high safety. And this is what we have demonstrated after 7 years in the market. We have done many clinical studies, and also we have developed a scientific model to calculate the temperature of the skin and of the hair. I will show you in the next slides more details about this work, about this simulation. Here, I only want to show you the results of prime lace with light hair, as you can find in skin type 1. Here you can see the high temperature of the hair using the prime lace. as you know, the temperature of the skin, we have to keep this temperature below 43. That is the to be always in a safe treatment, because at the end, prime lace should be a warranty of comfortable treatments, very effective and always safe treatments. Okay, here I show you the typical endpoint when you achieve very high temperature in the hair. This inflammation is not a burn in the skin. It's just the result of the burn of the hair inside the skin. And at the end is the effect of the high power of prime lace. And the difference between a really high power device like prime lace and another product in the market with much lower power. And just to finalize with the general differential factor of prime lace, I can say that we are offering a very stable technology with 7 years in the market and around 2,500 systems around the world. Some of our main customers are using the prime lace with a very intensive use. I am speaking about operation 10 hours a day during 6 days a week, offering the best results to their customers during many years, which at the end is the main proof of the excellent performance and high reliability of our technology of high power diode lasers. Moreover, prime lace has applicator with different spot sizes from 1 to 5 cm², and with different wavelengths. It means it's a very flexible platform that can satisfy all the customer wishes. And finally, I would like to mention that prime lace doesn't have consumables and does not require any important maintenance, being one of the hair removal devices with the lowest running cost in the industry. Then, now I would like to explain you why high power. We have said that prime lasers have the most powerful diodes. It has a superior power as compared to other diode lasers in the market. But why high power is key to have the best results for hair removal? Kuken Medical has done a huge investment in research. The proof is that currently we are around 30 people working in the research and development department of the company. And one of the most important objectives when we started the project of Prime Lace was to deeply understand the process of hair removal. We have developed a mathematical model to simulate the process of hair and skin heating during laser hair removal. And some of the results of this study can be found in this published paper. The hair removal process is not just the absorption of the laser by the melanin of the hair. It's important to understand and to take into account many physical properties of the skin. First, as you know, we find the first layer of the skin, the epidermis. Its color, white for skin 1 and black for skin type 6, come from a different proportion of the quantity of eumelanin and pheomelanin. And important, only the eumelanin absorbs strongly the laser radiation. The other important aspect to consider is the thickness of the epidermis layer, which is not the same in all the parts of the body. The second layer, where the hair is located, is the dermis. Here, there is no melanin, but it's a highly dispersive medium for the laser. And what is important to know is that this dispersion depends on the wavelength. The shortest wavelength, at 755 nanometer, suffers more dispersion than the longest wavelength, like 1060 nanometer. And this is the main reason why the penetration depth of the laser radiation increases with the wavelength. Although there is no melanin, there are other substances that can also absorb the laser, as the water. You know that the skin has a high percentage of water inside, and the blood or the hemoglobin that you have inside the dermis. Everything should be considered. And finally, we have the hair, which is the real target of the laser. Its color depends on the different amount of eumelanin and pheomelanin, like in the skin, but very important, we can find hairs with different size and lengths, and this is going to change their temperature during the laser irradiation. It's not the same as fine hair or a thick hair. And also, we will have different results with short hair than with long hair. Another important aspect to know are the different parts of the hair follicle. The hair itself has a long and thin part that is called shaft, and ends in a bigger part, which is called the bulb. Both parts have melanin and are the parts that are heated due to the absorption of the laser to the laser. But the real target of hair removal is not the hair, are the cells that are located in the dermal papilla and in the bulge. Because if you want to produce a permanent effect, it's necessary to destroy the cells to avoid that new hair appears after the hair removal session. Therefore, it's important to burn not only the hair, but also the cells located in the surrounding tissue. We have developed a 3D model that simulates the process of hair removal, taking into account all the parameters of the laser and all the parts of the skin. Also, of course, we have considered that the skin is cooled by the sapphire tip of the applicator. And here, I show you the physics we used to do the simulation. A first equation to calculate the diffusion of the laser in all the tissues, another equation to calculate the temperature of all the different tissues, and finally, a equation to determine the damage, which is finally the parameter that we can use to estimate the efficacy of hair removal. Here, I would like to show you an example of the simulation where we just want to compare the results using 4,000 words as compared with a standard laser with a power of 400 watts. In both examples, we have the same energy, 20 joules, and the same wavelength, 800 nanometers. The only difference is the pulse duration, 5 milliseconds for the prime laser and 50 milliseconds for the other lasers. In this example, we are considering a thin light hair and a scheme type 1. And here you can see the results of the simulation. Here you clearly see that the temperature achieved using 5 milliseconds is much higher than with 50 milliseconds, despite using the same wavelength and energy. Using prime laser, the results are quite good for the thin and light hair. However, the low power laser does not increase the temperature of the hair high enough to produce thermal damage, and then no results would be obtained. The reason of this different behavior is due to the thermal relaxation time of the hair. Here you can see a drawing that illustrates the heating of the hair and of the surrounding tissue for different pulse duration. When the pulse is very short, all the energy of the laser is used to heat the hair. However, when the pulse is longer, part of the energy is lost. So in order to have high effective hair removal, the pulse duration of the laser should be lower than the TRT of the hair. It's important to know also that not all the hair has the same TRT. Okay. The hair itself has different TRT in the shaft and in the bulb. Here we want to show you the TRT of untreated fine and thick hair. Okay. It means with its original size before hair removal and the TRT of the residual hair that appears after some sessions. With the thick hair, you can have results with many lasers. Many lasers will hit the thick hair because the TRT is long. But with the thin hair, it's important that the pulse duration is shorter than 20 milliseconds. But for the residual hair, here we will find the differences between the high powerful laser and a low or medium power laser, because only with the high power and short pulses you will obtain results. Look that the TRT of the residual hair is shorter than 7 milliseconds. Then you should use a high powerful lasers with a very short pulse duration to achieve really good results with the residual hair. Just to give you another example of our simulation work, this table shows the calculation for a skin time 2, for example, and for all the types of hair, light, brown, black, and having different dimensions, fine or thick. And here we compare a laser with a 4,000 watts with a laser of 1,000 watts. And we use the maximum fluence of 40 joules for by centimeter square. With the first laser, the pulse is 18 milliseconds. And for the second laser, the pulse is 72 milliseconds. Here in the table, we show first the temperature of the skin. Okay, this information is important in order to evaluate if the skin can be damaged or not. And then we show the temperature and the thermal damage of the shaft hair, of the stem cells located around the shaft, and the temperature of the bulb and of the cells located in the thermal papilla. And at the end, we show an average of the thermal damage of the hair follicle structure. From these results, we can understand much better the differences in efficacy for all the cases using high power or medium power. Okay, We know that the high power of primates is a guarantee of good results, and that all of this technology and knowledge can be used to achieve the best compromise between results, efficacy, and profitability. Then, which are the benefits of the or the blend technology? Why we are using blend? Recently, we have published a paper about a clinical study where we compared primlase with its applicator of 800 nanometers and the blend with another laser of less power. And the conclusions were better results with high power and better results for the blend for the dark skin types. Let us to understand better the results. What we show here is the temperature of the skin of the epidermis for the different skin types from 1 to 6. Here you can see that for skin type 1 and 2, we should decrease the fluence below 20 joules per centimeter square. Otherwise, we could damage the skin. This picture shows a simulation of a high skin type when we use a fluence just in the limit, okay? But if we use a higher fluence, then the temperature would increase and produce a damage. Then it's very important to know this information to use a fluence that never would produce a damage in the skin, okay? And this is the same picture for the blend applicator. Our work of simulation reveals that the blend could be used with higher fluences also for the skin 4, and what should decrease the fluence only in the skin types 5 and 6. The reason is because the blend wavelength is less absorbed by the skin than the 800 nanometer wavelength. Then the epidermis is less heated, and therefore we can use higher values of fluences. This is very important because it means that with the blend applicator, we can achieve very similar results with an skin type 1. Okay, here you see the results of the simulation with an skin type 1 than with an skin type 4. You can see that the temperature of the epidermis is higher. Here, you can see the temperature of the epidermis is, is higher for a skin type 4. And still is 43, and we will not produce burn. But the temperature of the hair is almost the same than obtained with the skin type 1. This result is not possible to be achieved if we would have used the 800 nanometer wavelength. Here I show you our treatment protocols for 800 nanometer and for the blend applicator. For the 800 nanometer diodes, you see that for skin type 3, we recommend to decrease the fluence. And for skin type 4, 5, and 6, to use longer pulses and lower fluences in order to protect the skin. It means that the hair removal results will be worse for high skin types because of using lower values of fluence. However, our protocols for the blend applicators include higher values of fluences for all the skin types. Here, we can observe that the values recommended for skin type 3 are very high. Here you can see. And for skin type 4 are also high, almost the double than with the 800 nanometer applicator. But we can continue using short pulses. Also note that for skin type 5, we can also recommend relatively high values of fluences and with 30 milliseconds instead of 100 milliseconds that we recommend for the 800 nanometers applicator. Here, I want to show you just some example of simulation with black fine hair in skin type 2 and in skin type 4. For skin type 2, we would recommend 25 joules with the 800 nanometer and 35 joules with the blend. And we can observe that the results could be slightly better with the blend. But the most important difference is with the skin type 4, where we should reduce the fluence. We should reduce the fluence with the 800 applicator to 50 joules, 15 joules, and pulses, and to use pulses of 30 milliseconds, giving a low hair removal efficacy. While with the blend, we could use up to 25 joules by centimeter square and obtain a very good hair removal results. These are before and after photographs of armpit from a subject with skin type 4 and dark hair, where the left side was treated with 800 nanometers and the right side was treated with a blend using the recommended parameters from the protocol. The hair removal reduction after 3 sessions with the 800 nanometer laser was around 15%. While the reduction with the blend was much higher, we obtained around 46% of hair reduction. Okay, now we have understood better the improvement of the blend wavelength as compared with the 800 nanometer wavelength when the patients have very high skin types. But why? The combination we have 800 nanometers, 940 and 1060. Why of this combination? I will try to explain you. The first important key factor to take into account is the lifetime of the laser diode. Perhaps you don't know, but the lifetime of the 800 nanometer diode is much longer than the lifetime of the 755 nanometer diodes. Here I show you one picture that compares the lifetime as a function of the temperature of the laser diode, of the internal temperature of the laser diode. When the diodes are operated under the same operation conditions, it means same power, same pulse duration, same frequency, they are heated internally up to similar temperature. We can consider, for example, that the diodes are heated up to 85 centigrade degree. In that condition, the 800 nanometer diode would have an expected lifetime of 55 million shots, while the 755 nanometer diode would achieve only 7 million. It means that if we would have been use 755 nanometer diode instead of 800 nanometer diode in our blend, the lifetime would be very, very limited. So if we want to have high lifetime diodes, 800 nanometer diode is a much better option. At the end, the lifetime is related to the profitability of the diode. We have understood that the 755 laser diode have a high degradation when running at full capacity. This, of course, will limit the speed of operation and the use of high fluences because these conditions produce a high diode heating. Therefore, the use of high 100 nanometer diode instead of 755 for the blend applicator allow us to use high speed operation without any restriction of fluence and frequencies, always with the highest lifetime. So we can conclude that the use of 800 nanometer diode is a warranty of high profitability. Other key factor to consider when comparing 755 with 800 nanometer is the power. Due to the technological limitation of the 755 nanometer structure, the power of the 800 nanometer diode is a minimum 50% higher than with the 755 nanometer. What is the direct consequence? That the pulse duration with the 800 nanometer diode is much, much shorter than with the 755 diodes. Here, We can compare, for example, the table for the dynamic mode for our applicator of 800 nanometer and the 755 nanometer. Just compare the pulse duration at 10 joules. For 755 nanometers, the pulse duration is just 6 milliseconds, and for the 800 nanometer, the pulse duration is 4. Then, why is important the pulse duration? It's important for the efficacy. Again, I show you an example to compare the results using 755 and 800 in two different cases. The first case is a skin type 2, brown and fine hair. For the 755, we use 30 joules by centimeter square, and for the 800 nanometers, we use 35 joules. In both cases, the epidermis temperature is the same. You see, it's 37. But for the 800 nanometer laser, the results of efficacy is much higher because of using higher values of fluence. The same happened with the skin type 4. The fluence is more limited for the 755 nanometer because it's higher absorption by the melanin of the skin. And this means that the result with the 800 nanometer diode would be higher using this wavelength. As a conclusion, the 800 nanometer diode provides higher efficacy than the 755 nanometers in low and in high skin type for thin hair. And the third reason that justify why 800 nanometer is better option than 755 is related with the comfortability and safety of the treatment. We have seen that the 755 diodes decrease the peak power of the blend applicator, or would decrease the peak power of the blend applicator. And therefore, this would increase the pulse duration. And we know that the sensation of pain increases with the pulse duration. You know that it's not the same to be at a hot temperature during a short time than during a long time. This means that if we would have used 755 in the blend applicator, then we should have produced a higher sensation of pain, and moreover, we would have decreased the efficacy. Regarding the safety, we know that 755 is more absorbed by the skin. And the main objective of the blend applicator is to be used with high skin types. So, using 800 nanometer instead of 755 will allow us to offer a safer solution for the dark skin types. We have tried also to innovate in the blend, adding 940 diodes to the blend applicators. Why? Why 940? The first reason is because 940 increases safety for the dark skin types, since it is less absorbed by the melanin. This is clear. The second reason is because 940 is 14% less scattered by the dermis than 800 nanometers. This would increase the penetration depth. And the third and important reason is because 940 is 27% more absorbed by the blood than the 800 nanometers. This would help to the follicle heating. At the end, we can say that the 940 would decrease skin temperature, would increase the penetration depth, and enhance the hair heating through the blood absorption. The next key factor that I would like to highlight is the flexibility of the blend applicator. Here, let me to show a picture where we represent the expected efficacy of hair removal for the different skin types from 1 to 6. The result for the 800 nanometer start decreasing from skin type 3, you see from the picture. However, the result for the blend are almost constant between skin types 1 to 4, as you can follow from the picture, and better for and better than 800 nanometer from skin type 3. So we can conclude that the combination of our three wavelengths offer a very good compromise for all skin types and allow us to obtain better results for high skin types. Here, you can see the before and after pictures obtained with a skin type 4, where excellent results were demonstrated. So, just to finalize with my webinar, I would like to summarize with the main benefits of the blend applicator of our prime lens. We can offer excellent results for low skin types 1, 2, 3, and 4, and thin hair. There is no loss of results for skin type 6. It's obtained much better results for skin types 5 and 6 than other single wavelengths. And thanks to the using of 800 nanometer instead of 755, we can offer long lifetime, higher power, higher profitability, and to be less painful and safer. And thanks to the contribution of the 940, we have more safety and penetration depth and higher hair heating with this wavelength. Okay. Thank you very much. It has been a pleasure for me to do this webinar for you. I hope you have enjoyed the webinar and you have understand better the benefits of the blend applicator. And now is a time for questions. Thank you. Okay, the first question is, what's the recommended pulse duration for blend? The recommended pulse duration for blend, as in all the diodes, is the minimum pulse duration, you can use. But this would depend on the skin type. For example, for the skin type 1 to 4, we recommend always the minimum pulse duration. For skin type 5, just to protect the skin, we would recommend 30 milliseconds. And for skin type 6, we would recommend 100 milliseconds. Okay, the next question is, how wavelength of blend and pierce mixed? How wavelength of blend can be mixed and okay. The other questions is regarding the penetration depth, of the different wavelengths. Okay. Then in the blend applicator we have three different wavelengths, 800 nanometer, 940, and 1060. The penetration depth increase with the wavelength. It means that the penetration depth with 800 nanometer is less than with 940 and less than with 1060. It means that we would achieve a complete penetration depth with the combination of the three different wavelengths, and this, as a result, the hair will be heated in a very homogeneous way thanks to the combination of the three wavelengths. 800 nanometer is less, the penetration depth is less, 940 is medium, and 1060 is higher, and then we can achieve all the parts of the hair. Okay, the next question. Okay, the next question is about the microchannels. What is the microchannels and why is important not to use microchannels? Okay, the microchannels is the diodes. In order to cool the diodes, the heat sink has internal channels where the cooling liquid pass to cool the diodes. Then the micro is the size of the channels. It's a very small size. And due to this small size, the cooling efficacy of the microchannels is very high. This is a very important, a very good method to cool the standard laser diodes. But for the laser diodes for hair removal, it is not necessary to use microchannels because the average power is not too high. Then we can use another type of channels, not micro. We can use a big channels, okay, good enough for hair removal, for the power of hair removal, but without the limitation of the micro channels, okay? This is macro channel, big channels, and then we will not have any problem related to the micro channels, problem of obstruction or problem of corrosion. And the cooling efficacy is good enough for the conditions used for the hair removal operation. Okay, another question. Another question is related why 940. This has been already explained during the talk. Okay, 940 is a very good compromise between many factors. For example, one factor is the safety. 940 has a few or a less absorption by the melanin than the 800 nanometer wavelength. Okay, then the use of 940 is a good option for the dark skin types. A second reason is the scattering of 940 is less than the scattering of 800 nanometer diode. It means that the penetration depth of 940 will be higher, will be longer. And the other factor, and also very important, is that the blood, the hemoglobin, will have higher absorption at 940 than at 800 nanometer diode. And then with this wavelength, 940, we can have different advantages. High penetration depth, less absorption by the epidermis, and more higher penetration depth due to the longer wavelength. What is the percentage of each wavelength in blend? Okay, here we have optimized the blend with all our research work. At the end, we have found that the best compromise in wavelengths is 25% for the 800 nanometers, 25% for the 940, and 50% for the 1060 nanometer. This is the percentage for each wavelength in our blend. Okay, the next question is regarding the problem when the hair become thinner after some treatments, and how we can adjust the laser parameter for skin type 4 and 5. Okay, when the laser become thinner, then it is important to use the shorter pulse duration as possible. Okay, then this is for all the lasers, not only for the blend. This is a problem for all the lasers. What is the advantage of the prime laser with the blend? The advantage with the blend and with the prime laser is the high power of the device, that you can use always short pulse duration, and then you will have good result from the beginning, from the first session, and also for the last session. And then this short pulse duration is a warranty of the best results. And then for all the treatments, also from the beginning to the end, from the first session to the last session, it is important to use always the higher fluencies that you can use and always the shortest pulse you can use, but always you have to be sure that the skin will be safe, okay? This will be your limit, to use a fluence to be sure that the skin is safe, okay? Under these conditions, use always the maximum fluence and the shortest pulse duration. Okay, what is the recommended setting for tan skin? A lot of centers will open now during summer and they want to start treating people immediately. Then for tan skin, it's important to know the effective skin type. Okay, for example, a standard skin type 3, when it is tan, it can become 4. Then you have to use the parameters of the 4 skin type. And what we can recommend for this kind of skin is to use dynamic mode. Okay, with dynamic mode, you will use lower values of fluences. Okay, with very short pulse, this means that this low value fluence with very short pulse will be effective, but not dangerous for the skin. Okay, this can be used for the first sessions, for session number 1, 2, 3, dynamic. Okay, and then when the skin is not tan, then you can shift to static mode to finish the hair removal session. Okay, the next question is if there are lasers with blend of 4 wavelengths in the market. It's more effective. Okay, the efficacy of the hair removal product at the end depend on how much fluence you can use for the treatment. For example, for the blend, we know the maximum fluence for each skin type. If we would have another combination of wavelengths, maybe this maximum fluence is different. And it is important to know the maximum fluence for each combination of wavelengths. For example, we know that if we would use 755 instead of 800 nanometers, we should use less fluence because of the skin, because the 755 is more absorbed by the skin. Then our combination of wavelengths, 940, 800, 800, and 1060, is a very good combination to work with a high values of fluences. Then for all the cases, it is important to know very well the absorption of these frequencies, of these wavelengths by the skin. And this, the skin absorption, will give you the maximum fluences you can use for every skin types. Okay. Is there any other indication than hair removal that we can use for primeless blend? Yes. Actually, we have developed protocols for rejuvenation, for rejuvenation treatment, and also protocols for acne treatment using the blend. Okay. For the acne, is because we have a combination of 940 and 1060, and then you can produce the heating of the hair and also the heating of the surrounding tissue, okay? And for the rejuvenation, it is using long pulses, you can also produce the heating of the dermis to 45 degrees just to promote the production of collagen or elastin. Okay, we have developed the protocols and we have the parameters recommended for these two applications. Okay. Okay. The other question is regarding the benefits or an even higher power system, for example, 6 kilowatts or 8 kilowatts. Okay, the benefits is clear. If the power is higher, for example, if you have a diode with a higher peak power, 6 kilowatts or 8 kilowatts, you could have a better efficacy. You could have better results because the power of the diode determines the length of the pulse. Okay, for example, the solid state lasers use high peak power and short pulse laser pulse. The thing is that the power is important, but we have to consider also the speed, the frequency, and the wavelengths. You can have a very high powerful laser of 755 nanometers of a high powerful of 800 nanometers, but you cannot use the power in dark skin types because the power will be limited by the heating of the skin. Then in that case, you should reduce the power and because you should increase the pulse duration. Then for skin types 3, 4, 5, is not only power important, it's also important the wavelength, because if you have a long wavelength or a combination of different wavelengths and also a combination of peak power, the two aspects, the peak power and the combination of wavelength, will give you better results than using high peak power but with a short wavelength. Okay, this is the reason why our prime lace 800 nanometer is worse than the blend. Even the power of our 800 nanometer laser is higher than the power of our blend laser. And the difference is just the wavelength. The wavelength is less absorbed by the skin, and this allows you to use higher fluence. Okay. And the last questions. Last questions. I'm sorry, I don't understand the last question. It is regarding this time. This time we're in the market is closed. I don't understand very well this question. I'm sorry, I cannot answer the question because I don't understand. Anyway, I will answer all the questions we have, and I will send all the answers by email. I would like to say thank you again to all the attendants. Thank you again to Skin Innovation for inviting me. And it has been for me a pleasure to be with you. And I wish you a very happy day. And we hope that we will recover a good situation very soon. Okay, thank you very much for your attention. Bye bye.